Hello crafters, so let's start with the simple oven background I have created on my Eclipse machine. Preferably for this one you should cut your background from two different colors for contrast, but of course you can use the same color if you wish to do so depending on your project. This is what you are going to get from the once the design is cut out. And I call this plain weaving. This will be available as SVG files on my Etsy store, and they will all be under the same folder, so therefore you only pay one small amount for two designs and one bonus design, actually two bonus designs. The size is 8 inches by 10. And let's get working to create our oven background. The reason I made it this way, it will be easier to snip it. So I chose to use as weaving strips, the black one. So therefore, this one I'm going to snip out the strips. So let's do this quickly. Doesn't matter whether or not it's perfect, because this will be the end of the strips which are not going to be visible in the project. So we have 8 strips which we are going to weave throughout our design. So first strip, I normally put it like on top and going under each other strip. And try and push it down as far as it goes. Now the second strip is gonna, I will start underneath the first strip and follow the same pattern. And push it down as far as it goes. Again, now I'm going back to the way I created the first one. So the strip is gonna be on top of the strip here and under the next one, and then follow the same pattern all the way. And then push it all the way down. Again, we are going to follow the next strip. So this goes underneath the first strip and then over and under each other strip. And we are going to do it the same way all the way until we finish all of our strips, or depending how many strips is going to hold. It should hold all the strips, but we shall see. Okay. Oops. So you get this nice checkered look background. Oh, okay. strips, so that means we are going to use all the strips under. The last strip is a little bit tougher because we are right there. So let's follow the pattern all the way. Just stubborn. There we go. So this is the simple oven background. I like to do my backgrounds a little bit bigger, somewhat bigger than what I'm gonna end up using, because I rather have the choice to cut down than not to have enough. Normally I like to create big cards, and my cards could be 8 inches or more, therefore I created this background on 8x10. But in case I need to choose it for a card which is 8x8, then I'm going to cut this on 8x8. Now we already know that this side is 8 inches, so I'm going to use my ruler to cut 8 inches this way. So let's do that quickly. Then my craft knife. Where are you hiding, craft knife? There it is. So I'm going to measure 8 inch from one side, and don't worry where it ends up, because like I said, usually the sides of the background are going to be hidden anyway, so they're not going to be visible on your craft. And don't mind my doggy upstairs crying after her mama. She is a great attention seeker. So we are going to cut it. Oops. Yep, that can happen too. Don't worry about it. Then I'll just use the scissors to end up to finish the cutting. Alright. And like I said, don't worry about the end of it, because it will not be visible. So now we are going to glue the ends. So just a little bit of dab of glue. Don't let me down now. Under each end. My god, it's like a storm up there. I have two doggies, a Blue Nose Pit, she's a wonderful dog, and the Boston Terrier, Robbie and Sasha. Robbie is the Boston Terrier, Sasha is the my PT, which is nothing but a sweetheart. To push this down properly here. Okay. All the way around, just sealing the ends so the background doesn't come apart. Great. Now turn it upside down and glue the rest of it. Another wonderful time to run out of glue. Properly. is not going to be visible. Just trying to press down so it glues on properly. And now with your scissors, quickly finish the ends. If you like to keep them for another, I'm sorry, I'm a bit of a perfectionist, I have to cut this properly. If you want to keep them on the side, some crafters do that just for another project, hey, you'll never know. So this is the simple woven background, but I don't like these ends, so we have to find a way to hide that, or depending on your project. I would like to use this background as a full background for my card, that I buy a card. So I have to find a way to actually cover these ugly sides. And for that, and this is part of my bonus design for these backgrounds, I have made a frame with a middle aperture. I don't know how much use this one, I'm gonna use the black one for this one. There we go. I have designed this to fit a 8x8 background. The original size in my SVG files, it's 10x10, because I wanted 1 inch border and then an extra inch border that is going to fold on the back. So in order to place this nicely and equally, what I'm going to do, I'm going to mark an inch, and this is not going to be visible anyway, so I'm going to mark an inch border all the way around. Score tape, I'm going to apply score tape very close to the design. Taking our oven background, I'm going to also apply score tape on all the way to just on the sides. I'm going to use a quarter of an inch for this one so we can have more coverage. Now let's remove the score tape and the cover. this on the side for a second. Let's remove the tape from this. Take our aperture or frame, however you want to call it, and the reason why I created these lines around it is to help me to place this equally or as equally as possible. So within the markings, within the lines, I'm going to press this down. Oh, and another thing, if you want, like for example, to put let's say one of the strips into the or at the end your design in the embossing folder, that's gonna make a nice it's gonna create a nice look as well. So this is how it's going to look. So this is what's going to hide the workings of the woven background. And give me 1 second because I forgot to take my perfect trimmer off. Because like I said, we are going to use this to dress the sides. So with the perfect trim ruler, I'm using the 1/4 of an inch, I think this is it. It's 0.125. If this doesn't look fine, it's gonna create a bulkiness in your card. So that's the reason I'm trying my best to keep it as perfect as possible. So we are going to price core tape all the way around the background and also at the bottom of this. I'm gonna use 1/4 of an inch. Keep them if you think you can use them for another project. Folder, I'm gonna try and already create like a band, like a score line, by holding down the background and trying to raise the side. Okay. So now we're going to glue this side down. Then with a bump folder, press it really well to stick. And then we are going to do the opposite side first, I mean second. So whatever side you start with, always glue down next the opposite side, and you'll see why. And this is kind of the rule that goes every time you are trying to dress something or to create anything, like even on a box, or to dress a box or cover something with paper, and you are creating this kind of coverage. Alright, so we glue the opposite sides, but as you can see here, we have like a little bit of margin left. See how visible is this? See here? So that we'll press it down, so at the point when we are going to bend this over, that corner there is in, it will be folded inside this side when gluing down. So I normally use my bone folder for that, but this is not the right bone folder, this is the right one. Yes, I have a bone folder for every little thing. So see, I'm just pressing that down. See how I press that corner there? Can you see now how it's bent in? So it goes for the opposite side. I'll squish it really down there. For some reason, this is getting stubborn. Just go around it and press it out. And see what this ruler helped me? When we bring these sides together, it creates the perfect line here. Like these sides meet perfectly or almost perfectly. It's not one bigger than another, or I know it doesn't matter because it's gonna. This is part that you are going to glue on your card, so you're gonna see this part. But still, it's a nice touch. But in case you're creating photo albums and you need to dress the covers, that will be something that will be visible if it doesn't come up properly. I had another ball for me, I cannot find it. You should do this with no problem. And again, use a ball folder to bring this up. I use 80-pound weight cardstock, so sometimes it has a mind of its own. This is a plain oval background, almost like a checkerboard with a nice aperture, and then we can put the embellishments of the cards, sorry, I'm trying to find the camera right here. Just to give you as an example, actually I've already showed you this. This is the card I've been working on. It's a birthday card, and as you can see, this oval background here. This is the background we're going to do next, and I call this background with a window because of these strips that here in the middle. So this background is glued on the card, and in the back the card looks like this. So this will open up from here. It's like a gatefold card in the back, and then the center will use this to write the note and then put it back in here. But this is how I glued the oval background to the back of my card, so it created a very nice look. So you guys see it straight. Thank you for watching, and once again, the three backgrounds that I'm going to show, each background I'm going to demonstrate in three different videos. They are going to be available to purchase all in one package on my Etsy store. My Etsy store, it's just as the same as my YouTube channel, it's Sandy Geek. The last background I'm going to show, including this aperture, are actually bonus. So in your price you are going to only pay for the plain background, for the plain woven background, as well as for the window woven background. Thank you so much, and have a good day.